The International Monetary Fund upgrades its growth forecast for China this year and the next. The IMF said Tuesday it expects the world's second largest economy to expand by 5.4% this year. That's likely up than its earlier forecast of 5%. The IMF said, though, that continued weakness in China's property sector and subdued external demand could restrict its growth to 4.6% in 2024. But that figure is still better than the IMF's previous 2024 forecast of 4.2%. The revisions follow China's decision to approve a $137 billion sovereign bond issue and allow local governments to front-load part of their 2024 bond quotas to support the economy. Chinese policymakers maintain their growth target of 5% this year is still achievable, despite what has been a troubled recovery for much of 2023. The National Economic and Development Authority now reiterates the government's objective of pursuing high-quality job generation for Filipinos. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan says they will work to improve investment climate to attract businesses that generate high-quality jobs. Among these improvements is the infrastructure development in areas outside Metro Manila. He adds the government will implement more programs to develop a more resilient economy, particularly the agriculture sector, to mitigate job losses. Data show the agriculture sector suffered one of the highest job losses in September, mainly due to bad weather conditions. Philippine farming output contracts for a second straight quarter. Data from the Statistics Bureau show production in agriculture and fisheries from July to September fell by 0.3%. This follows the 1.2% drop in the second quarter. Now, crops, which accounted for over half of the total production, registered a 4.4% decline in Q3. Fisheries, meanwhile, saw a 6.1% decline. The lone subsector which saw an increase was poultry, where output increased by nearly 3%. Here's a look now at some major earnings reports, starting with SM Investments. Its net income increased by 30% to nearly 56 billion pesos in the first three quarters of the year. The firm says this is thanks to solid customer confidence. Meanwhile, during the same period, Ayala Land recorded a net income attributable to equity holders of 18.4 billion pesos. That figure is 38% higher year on year. As for DNL Industries, it ended the nine-month period with a net income of 1.8 billion pesos, which represents a 29% decrease year on year. Finally, for Century Pacific Food, its total comprehensive income grew by 9.6% to reach 4.6 billion pesos in the first 9 months of 2023. State-run pension fund GSIS pouring in 1.45 billion pesos into the renewable energy firm Alternergy. GSIS chief Wick Veloso signed Tuesday a deal with Alternergy chairman Vince Perez for the agency's subscription in the firm's preferred shares under a private placement. Veloso says the investment is in line with the agency's commitment to sustainability and build a solid investment portfolio of renewable energy projects. He adds investing in renewable energy also provides a foundation for stable returns. Alternergy President Jerry Magbanwa, meanwhile, says the equity infusion from GSIS will strengthen the company's equity base as part of its medium-term capital raising program. Digital Pilipinas all set for the Philippine FinTech Festival later this month. Digital Pilipinas convener Amor Maclang says a good portion of the festival happening from November 20th to the 24th will be a crash course on ASEAN as they seek to position the region as an investment hub.
One thing that we realized is most of the attention of the world, 40% in 7 years, will be directed towards ASEAN. And many of the global programs do not necessarily focus on ASEAN as an economic giant. And for the first time, the Philippine FinTech Festival, our theme is about World Meet ASEAN.
If you love your wine, then you may not like this next story. Global wine output has fallen by 7% on the year, resulting in the lowest wine production in 60 years. Now, according to the International Organization of Wine and Wine, or Vine and Wine, extreme climate conditions such as early frost, heavy rainfall, and drought have significantly impacted the output of the world's vineyards. Now, the OIV estimates some 244 million hectoliters of wine will be produced in 2023, the lowest global output since 1961. In case you don't know what a hectoliter is, well, it's equivalent to about 133 standard wine bottles. So yes, there's still a lot of wine out there to enjoy this coming holiday season.